Hi, welcome to our garden. We're Cheri and Dave Felton. We are so glad that you are here. We live in Brookhaven, have been here since 1986, and we are so thrilled that you have come to see our garden today. And I'm going to try and give you as much information as I can. If I miss something, please feel free to contact us. This is an island that originally was covered entirely with hostas. When we remodeled the house, and widened the driveway and the garage and everything, it changed. David planted these. These are Trompenberg maples, and he planted these when they were probably 12 feet high, and they are absolutely gorgeous. They have beautiful color in the fall and the spring. So we have added back hydrangeas. We've added back hostas. This little bitty one here is something called pink Cheri that Ozzy gave us that is just beginning to grow. It's the first time it's bloomed, but it's really a pretty color pink. I grow daffodils because I think they're pretty. My painted ferns have done wonderful this year. And as you can tell, we like hostas. All the hydrangeas that you see along here, and these blue ones, and these pink ones over here are endless summer. These get much more sun. These are much happier. But the interesting thing about hydrangeas, I think, is people always will say to us, I want it to be pink, I want it to be blue, I want it to be something. I want you to see this one at the bottom of the hill here. It is a hydrangea for all people. It has a white flower, it has a purple flower, it has a blue flower, it has a pink flower, and in the back it has a lavender flower. So, all of this from the experts about soil controls. That one lives right next door to it, and it is entirely blue. We have played the mulch game through many years. With you name it, we've tried that kind of mulch. We have a home in Florida, and this year they put in cypress mulch. And I came home and said to David, this may be the answer to our issues. We have a lot of stone walkways, so we have used the cypress mulch in between the stone walkways, which we think is really going to help. This is to the backyard. I put hostas all along here like it was originally, and I hope they're cushiony to walk on. They say they adhered well. These are akubas. I love akubas. I think the variegated akubas are so pretty. And these are some gardenia bushes that were hurt by the snow. But this year we took out a climbing magnolia that was out of control, and we put in, David, what are those called?
Fashadera.
Fashaderas. And they will climb. They need a trellis. And these again are endless summers. Those are lime hookeras. And this is a Patriot hosta. These are variegated pittsporums that were put in this year when we redid this area that we liked a whole lot. This is another hydrangea that came from Ozzy. It's called White Wave. No, Hillary.
Hillary?
From Hillary, yeah. And it's called White Wave, and it's blooming, and it's really pretty. I love the little teardrops.
Yeah,
okay. We can go this way, maybe. No, we don't want to go that way. There's a big pile of leaves. We'll go this way.
This one we don't water yet. We bought this before. The Spanish nursery opened and just cleaned up. And they had them all labeled blues something.
Nico Blues. This is tiny tough stuff, and a lot of our macrophyllias are not blooming this year because of the late freeze and the 2 days. We don't know. This is in this pot, this funny pot here is a sport of one of those that we just stuck in a pot to grow, and it's growing. The dark plant you see down there is a viburnum that blooms and is pretty. And this skinny plant right here is the most beautiful viburnum you'd ever seen. It has a lace cap flower. I sent all the people in the Hydrangea Society a picture of it. We saw it originally at Michael Durer's, and it is just wonderful. Okay, we'll go this way. This is another macrophylla, no blooms.
We don't know what these are.
And we don't know what they are. They came out of a house, a lady didn't want them. I sell real estate, and she said, "Will you dig those up? I'm throwing them away." This is a lemon daddy that came from Aussie. We have two of them. The first year, the one down by the pool had beautiful white flowers on. They've never bloomed again. These are Annabelle's, David. Those are Annabelle's. And those are some irises that need attention. What's the purple one by you? Yeah, the purple bloom on it is huge. Okay, we go this way. This is an Edgeworthia. I have three of them. They get wonderful scented white flowers on in the winter. They are just fabulous. They're an evergreen plant. I love different little plants like that. These are camellias. There's a Sanquis that got some kind of leaf something or other this year and they aren't happy. This is a Mahonia. Don't get close to it. It will stick you. Oh, and those big green things we passed are Limelights and Tardivas, but they're not blooming yet. Okay, this again is another Viburnum. These are three vanilla strawberries that supposedly like the sun and have never bloomed and never grown. I'm giving them to my son. This is Alice. This is an Alice. And I want you to notice this Alice, because I have another Alice I'm going to show you that people tell me is the same plant, and it's very hard for me to believe. This is a diadem that froze, and it's actually going to bloom a little. We don't know what if it's going to get any leaves, but it's blooming. And this is Goliath, and he doesn't like the sun, but in the morning he's all perked up. Oh, this is Silver Dollar. Didn't bloom. This is Lilacina. Oh, that's Ruby Slipper. Okay, this is Lilacina. One of the members brought one of these to a meeting one time and it was so pretty and he brought us one from his yard. And so it looks like it's really gonna bloom. It's full of flowers. These are plum yews, which I really like. This is Blue Bunny. I would say 7 years ago, we went to Henderson Mill down south, Wilkerson Mill, and we bought Blue Bunny. Every year the dog would chew it and eat it. Every year the dog would chew it and eat it. Last year the dog got to be 12 and she died. So no buds, but at least it's a real plant this time. This is Bluebird. And that's my Daphne. We used to have another one right there. This winter, David walked out and he said, "It's dead." We buy Daphnes and camellias from a nursery south of Macon. He grows this Daphne, which he said is grown for this climate, and he swears it will live. But as anybody who knows who grows Daphnes, they just look at you one day and die. But they bloom in the winter and they have wonderful scent. And this is Enzizonodome or something. I don't know, it's one we got from somebody at the show. And what was this?
This is a story I started to tell about moving stuff in the front. These three in the summers were out front where we have blooms starting out, and the sun was killing them. So I moved them back here. They were almost dead. And put them in the shade and they just were fine.
And these are all camellias that bloom. What is that?
Bobo.
Bobo, okay. And this is? And this is ruby slippers. This is a test plant that came from Avi that he said needs to be in the sun, although it has a bloom on it. And he swears that next week when he comes to my house, he's going to move it. We've made a place for it. This is a variegated hydrangea, which you can see is not going to bloom this year. The macrophylla, another one. These just aren't going to bloom. This one that is blooming, I don't know what it is, but I'm going to get somebody here someday who can help me. We love them, we plant them. This
is BGI.
This one is a sport of these. This is one of the original plants when we bought the house. It was in the pine island out front, and we moved them to the front, to the back rather. This house was built in 1963, so how old that hydrangea is, I don't know, or what it is, I don't know, but it's really pretty, and it grew this the other day. And then this is Sister Teresa. This is Dear Dolores. This is Ladies in Red. It has kind of red stems, you'll notice. That's another, as I walk on a hosta. That may be another one of those oak leaves. That's No Queen, okay. We'll go back this way. Pinky Winky. These are rhododendrons. They don't look like anything, no. Their name is Anna Rose Whitney. I want everybody to look her up. She's the most beautiful rhododendron you've ever seen. She has bright pink double flowers, and I'm not exaggerating. I will send anybody a picture of them if they want. They are gorgeous. I moved the original ones from the front, and I could actually buy some at Pike's. What's this?
This is Quickfire.
This is Quickfire. And this down here is an area we haven't really gotten to yet. These are some hydrangeas that have come from Hillary, I believe. This is Blancmange, which is going to bloom. And this is, they were put in this fall. And this is another white wave like the one you saw up there. These are all plants that came through Hillary, that are through Kristen that she sent me. And this is Corsage. So I'll be interested to see the difference. She's in the Oregon area, how they do in the first year here. The one by you, David, is?
Limelight.
See, they're not blooming yet. This fenced area here is David's dahlia garden. You can see a red one blooming. He grows dahlias. They require sun, so they're a real challenge in our backyard. This is another Snow Queen. I don't know what that little one is. That's another. These are camellias that are fighting with those oak leaves. I have peonies that are finished blooming. This is another pretty viburnum. This is just so precious this year. Yes, cherry explosion. Isn't he pretty? Peonies, more of my hostas. This is a Merit Supreme that has never bloomed before. This one. And this is the other Lemon Daddy that I said bloomed so pretty by the pool this year. Now, if you remember, I talked to you about an Alice up there. We bought this hydrangea from Pike's. It was labeled a Snow Queen. The pistils are 17 inches long. The leaves are gigantic. This year, it's probably 5 years old. It's pink, and now people tell me it's an Alice. But it's really hard for to believe that and this are the same. It was supposed to be this with these little leaves. Snowflake, and it wasn't. This is an interesting bed. A number of years ago, Kroger sold hydrangeas and we went and bought them. Here it is. It suffered from, it froze late. It's not doing as well as it normally does, but they love the sun. And this is Munchkin. This is our contorted filbert that was put in when we remodeled the house, and we love it. It actually gets nuts in the summer, although I have never done anything with them. These big, enormous trees you see here are cryptomerias, and they were put in probably 1986 or 7, and they have grown like that, and they are just the most precious, beautiful things. They sway in the wind, they are gorgeous. In England, they live 100 years. And that shrub you see here came from Michael Doerr, and it's a globose, a small cryptomeria. It stayed about 3 feet tall and didn't grow until this year, and it has tripled in size. This is a little lime, and I think it's going to bloom. Yeah, I know. And then we put these green things in that are called, what are they? Linebackers. It's a new line that's come in because another plant that they replaced was not doing well. That's where Ozzy's sun plant is supposed to go that he hasn't done anything with. So let's not talk about that anymore, and we'll go this way. This is, what is this? It blooms and smells. Sweet shrub or something. Okay, we go this way. I put these evergreen creepy things here just because we needed something along this driveway. This was here when we bought the house. These are endless summers again, and they have just, there used to be three of them, and now I think there are five of them. Do you know what this is, David? We don't know what that is, and we aren't sure what these are, but this is sort of our oak leaf garden. We have two Japanese maples out here, and I love the soft touch hollies. I think they're so pretty. This is Fuji waterfall. We have this one here with those big flowers. We have another one, and that's another contorted filbert. And that is a coral bark maple, in case I forgot to tell you. That came from Costco. And these are all bloomstrux. And that is a camellia that was original to the house. And that is our garden. I hope you've enjoyed it. We've loved having you here. And if you have any questions at all, please feel free to contact us.